paradigm shift.
An educational comedy.
It's not a cause. Not a movement.
It's not a social group you can slap a label onto.
It's an idea. It's an intention.
It's an intuition.
A mindset in which reality can be explored.
It's a genuine expression.
Discernment.
Critical thinking and imagination.
To look inward upon ourselves.
To better understand the external world around us.
And yes,
few egos are bound to be bruised.
With our silly, strange, politically incorrect,
style of going about
real and raw honesty,
which invites you to be
to the fullest.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. Truth Finders Network is proud to present episode 2 of Make That Change, Tools of Transformation. This is part 1 of 3-part series of what I call the 3 C's of success: confidence, courage, and character must have for success. Yes, they are. I am your host, Kari Light, a.k.a. Scary Kari. I'm founder of Truth Finders Network and Glow Ministries, and as the mother of 7 grown children, ages 17 to 35, and grandmother of 11, I can honestly say that if I can find pathways to success, anyone can. That is what has inspired me to create this show and what motivates me to stay strong no matter what. I've been through a lot in my life, and I live to share what I've learned, and that is how it is with my co-host tonight, making the most amazing gathering of women. I've got Deborah Hernandez Antich, Katerina Roy, Mary Adams, and Jennifer Pennington, each wise sages in their own right. This truly is a special panel who bring energy, light, love, and joy to everything they do. And you will feel it carry over our cyber wires as we gather live tonight and as you share the podcast too, inspiring and motivating you to make that change. Real quick, a couple things that I want to mention before we jump in is hopefully some of the technical difficulties that we had last week keeping us from joining the chat room and taking callers have been cleared up. Although we may have a few more, you know, this is live TV, live talk radio, and it happens. But no matter what, we're going to get you the message of confidence, which is what we're talking about tonight. You can chat here on our Blog Talk Radio show page. However, while I'll be monitoring both of our chat rooms, I'll be participating in the network chat room. That's where I'll be watching for questions and comments that you'd like mentioned on the show tonight. You can join our small TFM chat room on the TFM homepage, or you can also click on the Truth Finders Network name in the upper left-hand corner and get the chat room on one page, and it'll be easier and to read and use. I'll see them as one, though, and I hope to catch all of your feedback, but we're grateful for your calls, too. So just call 949-943-1622, and when you do, you can either listen online or just ask to join the conversation by selecting one and then just hang out until I can get to you. So again, we would love it if you'd share our links to Facebook and the TFN network, www.truthfindersnetwork.com, as well as right here on our Blog Talk Radio show page, because we hope to reach as many people as possible. And by following us on Facebook and Blog Talk Radio, you will always be updated and connected. Okay, folks, we have a great show tonight, and we want to thank you for joining us and start by introducing my extraordinary and beautiful guests. And as I'm doing that, I'm going to kind of check in with them here real quick and make sure that I've got them where I need them to be. Okay, so it looks like I don't have Mary with me yet. She is live, so are you? There you go. Perfect. So the guest that I have joining with me tonight are Deborah Hernandez-Antich. She's joining us from Leander a bit later in the show, and she is an intuitive consultant, an instincts trainer, and the founder of I Project Confidence and the Traveling Psychic Supper Club. Deb is also a child and victims advocate, a CASA court-appointed special advocate. Deb's dedicated to creating enriching experiences for those around her and viewing the world as an intuitive yet through an intuitive yet childlike eye. And you can contact Deb at Deborah@TravelingPsychicSupperClub.com and email her at Deborah@IProjectConfidence.com. I've also got Katerina Roy with me live. She is a life coach helping women heal their emotional and physical pain and rediscover what it's like to feel real passion and joy again. She is healed from ADD, anxiety, depression, PTSD, and fibromyalgia, and has helped many to do the same over the past 5 years with everything from their heartache to their back pain. I've got Mary Adams, who also joins me live, and is the co-owner of Co-Creator Radio Network, spreading and facilitating empowerment globally for 8 years, and really 24/7. She's a teacher, coach, and minister, and social media empowerment and catalyst with over 120,000 followers. You can find her at co-creatornetwork.com, and you can email her at co-creatormaryadams@gmail.com. And also joining me live tonight is Jennifer Pennington, who is a special education teacher for kids with autism at Betacheck Middle School in Austin, Texas, and is the founder of Live Freely, an organization designed to provide guidance, wisdom, and encouragement to women and children seeking to live a more free and fuller life. She's also currently working on her master's in counseling at Lamar University, and you can check out her work at Live Freely with Jen at Weebly.com or email her at livefreelywithjen@gmail.com. And by the way, don't worry, I will work on getting all of these various connections with my guests as we go through the show tonight. When each one of them is talking, I'll try to get that in the chat room. And if for some reason you're feeling like you need it and I haven't posted it, maybe it got lost in the thread, you just reach out or, hey, call us. Again, that number is, 949-943-1622, and I'm going to hand it off here to Mary Adams shortly, but first, I just want you to understand what we're doing here tonight. You know, times are tough, but success is still totally possible. What does it take? What does that actually look like in our daily lives? How can you overcome rough patches and take your goals to the next level, you know, to the level of success and beyond? Tonight, we'll elaborate on the first of the three C's for success, which is confidence. And as we do, we honor and embrace truth and wisdom, community style. And we encourage y'all to call in and, yes, join us in our chat room on the STFN website again. That's truthfindersnetwork.com. So I want to say that success is for everyone. It's not prejudice at all. Thank God, and everyone can achieve it. And yeah, we may struggle in some ways, but I don't want to let that define you or your future. And I want to encourage y'all, get your notepad out, you know, get the paper and pen one, get the one on your desktop or laptop device, whatever, but come on, take some notes. This is good stuff. So Mary, on that thought, I know you're bringing your magicalness on this word confidence tonight, and I just cannot wait to hear what you have to say.
Thank you so much, Kari. And I'm so excited to be here with all of you to have this conversation, because I feel that it is probably the biggest problem that I run into time and time again when I'm coaching people or teaching in different classes. It's amazing to me how often confidence seems to be our biggest issue. And you know, when I first started doing my own internal work a long time ago, it was probably 30 years ago, was when I really started looking deep and deciding that I had some changes that I really needed to make because my internal programming wasn't quite right. And within that, what seemed to come up over and over again within every problem was confidence. And we often think that we have a lot of confidence because we do well in school, or we, you know, succeed in sports, or we do well in our job. And yes, we do have a certain level of confidence, but we often hold ourselves back from the things we truly love to do because we don't believe that we're good enough. And so, and it sometimes manifests itself, you know, in not singing or playing a musical instrument.
Oh, wow.
It might be creative.
Yeah.
You know, creativity is blocked when we have a lack of confidence because we believe that our art or whatever we create has no value to anyone else.
Right.
And so confidence can be a really huge issue. It can also be a huge block to healing emotionally, physically, and spiritually. A block to healing.
Okay.
Absolutely. Because if we don't have our confidence in our own ability to heal, whether it be emotionally, physically, or spiritually, figuring grief, if you feel that you're going to be in that place all the time and you can't pull yourself out of it, well, certainly you have a confidence issue.
Yeah.
And I would say,
let's just break it down and make it practical.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. That's what the idea is. So it's a practical block.
Yeah.
That makes perfect sense.
Yeah. It is. And often it has threads that it's tied to from our past. And that's usually when I'm working with someone, you know, they explain what their problem is today, but I always know that there's a deeper layer, that there is always something to connect, you know, connected from the past that's happening. And so that's where we take a look. And what I often find as we take an exploration backwards into their past is that their father may not have been as supportive of them with their art and, you know, poo-pooed it. And it may not have even been a negative comment. It may have been, oh, yeah, that's nice, honey, thanks for the card, and went on to do his thing. And that child turned into an adult and held on to that their entire life, thinking that to create...
Okay.
And so... it gives an incredible opportunity for us to look deeper and find out where are those connections in our life. Now, I talk to a lot of people that lose their confidence when they get a divorce or a relationship ends or a job ends. And that's usually connected to old grief and not actually resolving the grief and also that self-blame that we have. And... you know, a wonderful way to work on cleaning pieces like that up are, you know, to once again look deep, but then to also take the time to clean up the mess. We don't usually clean things up properly, especially in relationships and difficult endings, and there's usually a lot of scraggling.
So really, cleaning up, I guess, kind of like, you know how they say it's got to get worse before it gets better. You kind of have to think like that, I think, a little, because it's not a bad negative thing. It's like a good thing that's going to bring confidence. But you got to maybe clean out some of the stuff that may not feel so good. So it could maybe be disguised, you know, as something negative, because you're right. I mean,
well, and
like Drano to the blockage.
Exactly.
Bam.
Exactly. I had a terrific teacher once, Mindy Odlin, who shared this presentation where she had two containers, two pitchers of water. And in one of them, she poured dirt into it and she stirred it up.
Right.
Well, no matter how much she stirred it up or how much it settled, that dirt was always in there.
Right.
Then she took a strainer. And she said, well, you start straining out and you get rid of it.
And you clean it up.
That's right. You clean it up. And what started to happen is that that water started to clean up. And pretty soon, yes, the water was a little
muddy. Then you've got the confidence to drink it more.
Well, absolutely. And so
take it in.
Exactly. And the thing about confidence is that we carry our baggage from the past into today. We carry it into relationships. We carry it into our interactions. We carry it into our family dynamics with our kids and our husbands and our wives. And so taking time to clean that up, it will automatically increase the confidence. And so I have a tool. I have some really cool tools.
Okay.
My favorite tool, and this is something I live by, and everyone
your favorite tool.
Yes, my
right
favorite
on.
Tool. This is something I use, and I actually brought show and tell.
So cool.
Yeah. So
I mean, I might be able to take a picture. And
well, it's not necessary unless you really want.
I mean, like I could possibly.
Sure.
I mean, you know, it could happen. I could possibly figure out how to take the picture really quick and upload it while we're on there.
And it goes back to a little story.
I'm scared to turn my phone off.
I had back surgery. I had been down for about a year and a half and was unable to walk. And my confidence was extremely low. And I was in that place with so much sadness. And I really thought I was never going to walk again. And my family tried to do everything, and I was going into a deep depression, and I was just so fearful of what the future was going to hold, but I needed something to grasp onto.
Right.
And so I started thinking to myself, well, who is my favorite superhero, you know? Because as a kid, I would pretend I was Supergirl and Wonder Woman.
Right.
And I thought, gosh, well, you know, maybe this will work. Maybe this will be something I can grasp onto if I believe that I'm Supergirl or Wonder Woman. So the first thing I did is I bought myself this cap, and everyone here can see it is faded, it is dirty,
yeah.
It is well.
That's a real thing.
Supergirl hat. I still wear this all the time, and I wear this often to work out because it hurts to work out. And part of my getting well now is I can do all sorts of things. And now we're building my body muscle by muscle.
Yes.
And so this Supergirl hat, when I put it on my head,
I freaking
am Supergirl.
Love that.
I know, right?
Someone needs to give me their camera so I can take a picture. If I turn my phone on, it's going to start blasting in the studio. And yeah, that would be awesome.
So,
and if you text it, I'll have it on here. And then I might actually get to take, like,
that sounds
share
good.
That.
That sounds great.
As we go, y'all are experiencing live our work in progress because although the Make This Change show was actually, you know, mini backstory real quick, it was conceived back in, December of 2013 because I knew that I was going to be getting insurance for the first time in my adult life. In over 15 years, and I was in a wheelchair too. And so I thought that I was going to get it together a lot faster than I did, but still in perfect timing. But I'm just saying that to say that this show, Make That Change, has been being built for our listeners long before we even met.
Yeah.
Before I met Katerina, before I met the gentleman that introduced me to Kat, before I met you. And I just have waited. And then I knew last week, wanting to get back into broadcasting, I knew this was what needed to be picked up right now. And beautifully, everyone was available. And we did come together live last week. And this crazy, amazing thing happened. And we just realized we were available and we all wanted and needed to do it. And so here we are. And that's kind of the history about Make That Change. But we're sort of learning as we go right now. It's not typical to do one of these shows live where we're all in one room. There's a few like glitches that you're going to see us come across. But I really think it's worth it. I really do. I think y'all are really going to find it's worth it. And coming really soon, with a little help from a friend, is video. I mean, we're going to be streaming on, I think, Google Hangout. I'd like to see us getting up on Ustream. That's probably going to take a little bit of sponsoring and donating from our listening people. But no matter what, the bottom line is, this is happening. And we're going to bring it, and we're going to bring it as hard and fast and real and true as we possibly can every week. And, you know, I'll take this opportunity to say that we all, each of us, encourage you to reach out to any of us at any time with your suggestions for show topics, for stories, testimonies that you've had, you know, things like that, because we really want to incorporate you into the show. But so, yeah, Mary, you really just, I love the way you put the practicality, and last week you had talked about deserving. You remember when we were talking last week and we were covering confidence, our first one, and one of the things that you brought, that the tool of deserving and knowing that you deserve. And you highlighted that again tonight, and I wanted to highlight that for you because that really ministers to me. Mm-hmm. And I didn't realize how much of a practical tool it is. You know, like a practical tool. Yeah. So I just want to get your thoughts on what Mary was saying about that cat.
Deservingness. I think that deservingness is something that we all face, and I currently am like, oh, I'm dealing with that. I went into the store today, and I wanted to buy candles. Stay with me for a second. But...
Well, I'm right here, baby.
we have these ideas about what we deserve in life. And
oh, okay. I see where you're going.
Right. Based on our levels of confidence. And so the store. I'm in the store, and I'm, like, looking at candles, and I'm looking around, and I'm having, like, a mild freak out because I realize that most of my time that I spend doing things is for a purpose. It's like I'm going to spend this money on groceries or on rent or on practical things or all of these sorts of things that are musts and needs and have to's.
Right.
And just like how we have this idea that we can't be artists or creatives or do whatever it is that we want to do in life because of our ideas about what it means to be. Today about buying $15 worth of candles, and I was like,
I
deserve this? And am I worthy of this? Like, am I allowed to have this? And it was a weird moment for me because I have made so much progress and so many strides in my life, and I've overcome a lot. And confidence is this thing that we always kind of come back to because it's like the stepping stone of our lives. We have to have confidence in order to go out on faith. We have to have confidence.
It's not really a naturally replenishable resource.
No,
we have to
keep getting it. You get a little bit, somebody comes along, and it's like, oh man, I worked so hard to get that part.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm thinking about, though, is that confidence is something that when you tap into something and you're confident in something that's greater than yourself, you know, call it God, call it whatever, the universe, you have this faith that you're being held by something. And your humanness is going to be this thing that waxes and wanes. And some moments you're going to be feeling prettier, some moments you're going to be feeling kind of ugly. And it's like, you know, these are our human moments and they're going to come.
Yep.
But that doesn't mean that your confidence has to go completely away each time that they come. Like,
right.
And it's something that you can tap into something that's beyond these little fragile mind states that we have.
Definitely.
You know, this is, I feel confident today because I look pretty, or like the conditional things. You know, so this moment where I'm in the grocery, or not the grocery store, I was in like a decorative place where I was buying fancy candles, and I was like, oh my God, I don't know if I can do this. And then I realized inside of myself, like, no, you work hard. Like, it's something that you can treat yourself, like you can be nice to yourself, you can be kind.
Absolutely. I mean, if you want that, there's a reason for it. And candles are very soothing.
You can find,
I mean, honestly, something, and in that case, maybe, okay, so you're looking at the $15 candle, and so you find the $3 candle, the mini version of it or something. But yeah, don't deny yourself of that. I mean, you know, if you've got to choose between that and food, I guess choose food but for sure. But I mean, honestly, you've really got to be able to reward yourself. I believe that with all my heart.
Right, yeah. And to have the confidence to know that, like, whatever you do in your life, you're going to be held, and whether or not you choose the candle, like, there's going to be more coming.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And it's like this idea that it's a constant flow to you that you can continue to tap into. And that's what I'm talking about, being held by something.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if your confidence feels like it's waning one day, and you feel like you're never going to be confident ever again, you're never going to be able to get back on the radio ever again, you're never going to be able to put yourself out there ever again.
Yeah.
You know, like, these are moments and times where they don't tell you the whole truth of a situation. So that's what I'm
saying. That's so true. I like that, where you don't hear the whole truth. What do you think, Jen?
I really thought that it was interesting, like, when we were talking about, like, it kind of actually goes back to earlier what you brought up, the Drano. And
oh, yeah.
Being the Drano. And, like, I think every time, Kat, like what you're saying, every time that I come across someone that says a mean thing, or if I, like, let's say I'm really excited about something beautiful that happens in my life, and that's building my confidence, and their response is, oh, I wish I had that, or, you know, these little things that we're talking about that steal that confidence, I think of it as, like, that stuff that's going in the drain, you know, that's, like, that stuff that's plugging it up and keeping it.
So you're actually talking about a reverse of that, too, because you're going to, you can corrode away the blockage with confidence, but you can also lose your confidence down the drain.
Oh, well, no, I didn't think of it that way, but I like that. Yeah.
But because that's what I saw when you
yeah.
said that, you
yeah.
know, because it's, you're wasting it, you're losing
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
And it has to be replenished.
Right. Right. And it takes work. Like, it takes work to be replenished.
It
like,
does.
I'm going to talk about, like, bring back in that stuff that we talked about this last week about the belief work, you know, and when you have, you know, 70% or 60% or 50% of what you hear is negative, or 50% of what you perceive or take on, you know, depends how good you are at reading body language. I can go up to 80, 90%, you know, it depends on
yeah,
the people
real.
You're around. Like, you're constantly getting fed these false, horrible beliefs, and those things are blocking what you have offered the world. And, like, I go back to, I love what Mary said earlier about, like, it may, you know, like the little girl who maybe wanted to play clarinet. And the dad, you know, like, he played the song the first time. And the dad responds with, yeah, that's cool. Can you go to your room now? Like, I want to hear the TV, you know? And that's such a small thing, but that was a plug in that child's strength, you know?
Yeah.
And as an adult, they're sitting there going, yeah, I wish I would have played the clarinet, or I wish I would have been an artist, or I wish I would have written, or I wish I would have learned to box, you know, or like whatever it may be, you know.
Definitely.
And it just keeps adding and piling in, and we have to find ways to pour in that Drano, to clean that out, because there's beautiful things down there. There's beautiful things.
Yeah, clean out and then fill up.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. As a mom, one of the things we talked about learning things from Oprah Winfrey. but as a mom, I realized right away that in order for me to be a good mom, which as a young adult, that was kind of my focus, I knew that I had to be a happy woman. That much I'd already learned. And I knew that I would have to love myself to love my children. I knew I'd have to love myself to love my husband, and for anything. And so I really, and that was not easy. Like, I had to tell myself that kind of thing all the time. And when I felt bad, I had to ask myself, okay, what's going on? Why are you feeling this way? You know, and sometimes I feel less confident when I'm physically weary.
Yeah.
I feel less confident
yeah,
when I am busy and I'm not organized. So
I'm not eating right. Mm-hmm. Like, when I don't eat right,
I just don't feel as much control, mm-hmm. and that really affects my confidence. And I think kind of starts to tie in with what I deserve. But I hear from a lot of people talking to me about what you were talking about. My mom was just mentioning that to me not that long ago. She was going to get something for herself, and she put it back. And then she found something else. And then after she'd gone down the aisle a little ways, she put it back.
Yeah.
And by the time she got to the register, she only had the groceries, and so deserving is such a practical thing, and making it replenishable and holding, it's kind of like when you're driving a car, right, and you've got to hold the gas, kind of right there, hold it, keep it steady. And when you feel yourself wavering in confidence, get practical about it and figure out why. And one thing that I want to say before we go to a quick break, and I am going to try to say this over and over again all night. That's one of my goals for tonight, is because I believe in repetition. I believe in it really hardcore. And one of the things that I've learned the hard way is time. Having, in this case, the confidence to wait. I've waited for a lot of things, I've waited for people. I've waited for opportunities. I've waited for health. Just so many different things. And now that I'm older, I can say waiting is a gift. And when you do not, there is beauty in waiting. That's one of my very favorite things to say, is there 100% of the time there is beauty in waiting.
Yeah,
if you don't see it, look for it, and you will see it. And in that waiting and the fret that comes when you don't want to wait, you're missing it. You're missing stuff that'll prepare you for whatever it is that you're waiting for or that you're trying to get the confidence for. So don't, if it's taking a long time and if you're not seeing the results that you want, do not give up. Be practical. And right now, I would say confidence, and that's why it's listed first in the three C's, is just, it's imperative. So on that, I'm going to take us to a quick break. We'll listen to a couple of songs. So do what you got to do, and I'll see you back on the other side. This is Truth Finders Network, and this is Make That Change. And you can find us at truthfindersnetwork.com. We are in the chat room. I'm actually logged in, and we are taking phone calls. And I am going to work on putting some of those links on our network page. And with that, I am going to take my lovely co-host for a quick break, and this is Make That Change, and I will see you on the other side. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back. This is Truth Finders Network, Make That Change. Tonight's episode is Tools for Transformation, Part 1 of 3, a three-part series of the three C's, tools for success you must have. And I have here with me tonight Mary Adams, Katerina Roy, and Jennifer Pennington, and hopefully real soon, Deborah Hernandez-Antich. And we are talking about confidence, and it's a big deal. We were talking to Mary Adams before the break, and she was sharing with us her favorite tool. And she was talking about her Supergirl hat.
And I just want to
give her
a chance to, where something just happened.
Anybody
turn on their mic?
Yeah. There you go. Much better. Whatever you touched. I know if I hear it, you guys probably hear it too. But anyway, she was talking about her Supergirl hat, and I wanted to give her a chance to kind of wrap that up. We had to skip out on you guys to break because that's real important. But we're back, and I want to wrap that up and bring you guys some more good tools confidence.
Roar!
Roar!
Well, you know, what I wanted to say is that the S is just a symbol of, you know, and so it can be anything for you that you tap into. For some people, it might be the power of the sun, or it might be the power, you know, that you get when you read your Bible, mm-hmm. or it might be the power that you get, you know, when you do something, you know, out of love for somebody else. So there's lots of different ways
right?
to cultivate that power and to
yeah.
give yourself that confidence again. And what's most important is that self-love and forgiveness. Yes, we all make mistakes, and we all have troubles in our lives,
yep.
and sometimes things don't work out. And if we continue to hold ourselves accountable every day of our lives and everybody else.
I like that, holding yourself accountable.
That's right.
And that takes confidence.
That does take confidence.
It's a lot to hold and carry with you every single
day. It is,
day.
But it's worth it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's worth it, you know, because we're spinning our wheels at something mm-hmm. all the time. We might as well be making it something that actually works.
Well, exactly. It takes the same amount of energy to be miserable as it does to be happy.
Maybe more.
Exactly.
I think so, too.
And so here's the thing, is that, you know, if you take that energy and you put it into yourself and you give yourself whatever reminder gives you confidence. So in the morning, I always listen to some kind of music that motivates me, that gets me going, that reminds
right.
me why I'm here. If I'm feeling down and low, I pick up the phone and I call Kat or I call you and I say, hey, I need to pick me up. And what I love is that we have a text message with all of us that do this show that's continuously going.
That's so beautiful.
I was thinking about that today.
Yeah.
And every morning, and I mean, all throughout the day, there's
start
so
morning.
Much love.
Good morning, love.
That's right.
Ladies, have a beautiful
it
day.
Matters,
yeah.
y'all.
It does matter. It makes a huge difference.
Yeah.
So in order to build your confidence, you have to build it for yourself. And it's
yes.
not about the external things. Your confidence should be in the time that you spend with your family and the quality that you put into that
yep.
relationship. That confidence.
Absolutely.
The confidence is living your dream and living your authenticity and doing what you believe to be true for you. That
indeed.
Confidence. Because
yep.
when you stand up and you let the paradigm go of what other people believe is good for you, and you truly step forward and be authentic to you and say, you know what? I can't be anybody else but me.
Yep.
That's when your confidence comes back. So I invite everybody out there to find whatever tool it is, and we're going to share a lot of them today, but tap into that confidence.
Definitely. And, again, make lists. Like, I was being really serious when I said take notes. You know, and I do that. Like, I take notes all day long about, like, stuff that might keep me organized, of course. But other notes, too, like different things that I'll hear, little snippets of this and that I know if I don't write it down, I'm going to forget, and then I get annoyed. And they're just little things that make me feel better. So, I mean, you definitely deserve to have confidence and to love yourself. And you want love in your life, then you better love yourself first. And everybody is deserving of that. And everybody should have the confidence. With that, I want to hand it off to my awesome co-host, this beautiful Katerina Roy, and hear what your thoughts are on confidence tonight and what you want to share on that.
I always like to think about take it till you make it.
Oh, my God.
That is one of my TV phrases.
I love that.
Ever. Because whenever anybody talks to me about confidence,
fake it
they
make
talk
it.
About, I guess I just got to fake it till you make it. Or like, they try to, like, muster
oh,
up.
So
it's this, like, fake, like, slimy, disgusting...
Yeah,
just salesman-y, like, kind of confidence, like, oh, so I'm the best thing since sliced bread. Like, you know, like, that's not smell your cologne from here kind of confidence, you know? Or girls, you know, like, I have to wear the tightest clothes, the skinniest clothing, my cleavage has to all hang out. Like I have to be this image of what I think a confident person is.
Right.
And it ties in beautifully with what Mary was saying, because real confidence, genuine confidence, is living who you are and being who you are every day, no matter what the world thinks, or no matter what your family thinks, and no matter what people that you used to go to high school with might think.
Indeed.
It really is about just how you are from a day-to-day basis and how you're living your life. Are you doing things based on what you think other people want from you? Like, are you doing things based on what you think your parents want from you? Some of the people that I work with, literally, like, they have issues. They're, like, 40, 50, 60 years old, and they are still making decisions in their life today based on what their parents wanted them to do. And their parents
right.
are dead. Their parents are dead or in nursing homes or like, oh, no, I could never get a tattoo. My mom would never let me. Or, oh, no, I could never do that because my parents have a cow. You know, like, they still have these thought processes that are ruling them.
Yeah.
I was like, where the hell did that come from?
I remember when my grandfather was little and he would always say nice things to me, and I had kids real young, at 15, and he would say, Carrie Ann, don't ever say you're bad. Say you're acting bad, but don't tell them they're bad or call them names or whatever. And I think that goes for ourselves as well. I mean, we have to have good conversations with ourselves and in terms of, yes, I deserve that. Yeah, mm-hmm. I should get that. Or no, I think I can wait. I think my budget will be better next week, and having the confidence to wait. Again, like I said, waiting is really important.
Yeah.
Fake it till you make it.
I hate that phrase. It's so gross. But the thing is, I will explain the flip side of that, because it really is a pet peeve of mine. Fake it till you make it in a sense of an energetic, like, you can fake it till you make it. Like, I understand where the phrase comes from. It's really good intention, but I think people misuse it. Fake it till you make it, if you're talking about trying on an energy of confidence, or you're trying on this idea that you can be something bigger and you can do something more.
Absolutely.
There is a different energy about that.
It becomes beautiful.
It becomes mm-hmm. something beautiful. It's not something you're efforting or something you're trying to force yourself into.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that you're allowing yourself to dream into. You're allowing yourself to be that rock star.
And then you become that.
Right. Like, think about you. The first time you ever picked up a microphone, you were probably having dreams when you were a kid about, oh, I wish I could be a rock star. I wish I could be... You probably had dreams just about getting up on stage and performing for people and having a radio show and doing that, but you were a performer.
I did public speaking, so much of it is in line with that.
Exactly.
You're right, absolutely.
You needed to step into that energy of being a performer before you could get on stage.
And confidence gives you confidence.
Yeah. Yeah, so you imagine yourself being a confident person and really use...
That's a really healthy faking it.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
because it's not faking it. You're creating
you're
leaning into it,
embracing it, and owning it.
Yeah, you're owning it totally. You're totally owning it, and that's why it's so important to use your imagination, like I'm saying. And that's my tool about confidence, is really being able to imagine vividly in your mind what this person looks like. I have a little story about it, because Paul actually, when we moved here,
and Paul's your husband.
Paul is my husband. Yes, Paul Roy. Paulito, yeah.
Shout out to you, buddy.
Paulito, we love you.
He is loved, I must say.
When we moved back to the country, because we were living in Costa Rica, for those of you that don't know, and we moved here in December of 2014, he had never, ever spoken or to address an audience, ever. He had never
Let me just make sure I understand this right. Before I met him personally,
he had never done any public speaking ever.
I almost, if I didn't know you as well as I know you, I wouldn't believe you.
Yeah, I can vouch for it.
You watched him.
I have watched this whole thing.
This is insane. He acts like he's done it his whole life.
And do you want to know why?
Because he's wanted to. And
he's been imagining it.
Yeah.
He literally...
He's gone through it in his mind. I see that. Yeah.
He has them down. He has body language because he imagines himself doing it. He is so vivid about how that looks. And he has been creating it in the 5D, in the ethereal world, this entire time. And even before we got here, Paul and I, we literally got here because it was a whim. Like, the spirit... come back to Costa Rica, but we knew that we were coming here with an intention. I came here to teach classes and to do in-person networking, much like we're doing right now, like actually creating networks of like-minded, like-hearted people, because I felt like Spirit was really commanding that I do that. And you know what? Part of me loves it, and part of me really wishes I was laying back in a hammock in Costa Rica still, but I know that I'm supposed to do this. But the reason that I tell you about Paul is that now he is doing these classes where he's teaching children and he's doing public speaking gigs and he's talking to rooms of 400 kids and he's done that before. And
you just would never know.
You would never know.
That is amazing. What a testimony.
I mean,
you may not know this man. I know this man. And I can just tell you that it is absolutely true what she's saying, and you know, if you believe in yourself, you just don't, you're not going to know really how empowering that is until you try it on.
Right. And I'm not even asking people to believe in themselves yet. Just imagine yourself being that way.
I'm going to take it a step further. I'm going to ask you to believe in yourself.
Exactly.
I really am. She's inviting. And that's good.
Some people aren't ready for it.
But
I'm
pushing you towards her invitation. Because honestly, it's really, because I'm telling you right now, if I can do the things that I've done, and I mean, anyone can do anything, really, that you set your mind to. And, I mean, I call on things in my life to get strength. I do. Mm-hmm. I don't want to take the credit for that. But I purposed myself to do it. And I believed that I could do it. Because, you know, I think I can. I will make it up that hill. And I'm telling you, those mantras help. What are your thoughts on that, Jen?
I love like when like Kat, what you were talking about the fake it till you make it thing, and you were when you were talking about that, you know, and I think of like, okay, I think of like, I'm gonna go there, I'm gonna think like at work, right? Like I walk into work and like I'm just some, you know, there are some days I'm just grumpy, you know, and I've got to do it all day, and like as a teacher I don't get 5 minutes. I'm lucky if I get to go to the bathroom. I mean, that's like,
yeah, like for real.
Like for real. Like sometimes I get home at 7, I'm like, oh my gosh, I have not gone to the bathroom since I woke up this morning, you know. But so
that's not good, by the way.
Just saying. All teachers are like, they're you're walking around.
There's a mom in me coming out.
Yeah, you're eating your lunch while you're talking to kids. Like, it's crazy. So anyway, so like there are days when like, you know, and like my job, like when I got my job, it was such a gift, you know, and moving in to work with kids with autism, but I didn't know what I was doing, you know. And so when I come to work and I have those grumpy days, and I also know that there are times like I'm sitting there with a kid and I'm going, man, I know there's an answer. Like, how can I help this kid solve this problem? You know, what can I do? What tool does this kid need? You know, and I'm like, man, I don't know what I'm doing. Like, I don't have a master's in special education, emphasis autism. You know, I don't have any of that. And so in those moments, I do have to do a little bit of that fakey till I make it, in the sense of not pretending to be someone I'm not, but in the sense of just stopping for a second and telling myself, like, you may not not feel right now, like, you're grumpy right now, like, you didn't get a lot of sleep, and, like, you poor kids have had breakdowns, and they're throwing crap across the room, and, like, you know, you may not feel like it, but you've got this. And then I have the same phrase I always say, there's always a solution. That's mm-hmm. the first thing I said in my head. There's always a solution, and I know that I can find it. You know, and that's my fake it till you make it. You know, I don't have the emotional. And then the other thought that I had real quickly was, Kat, when you said, when, you know, Carrie was saying, I'm telling you to believe in yourself. And I was saying, you know, like, I definitely saw a little bit of what you're saying, where there's some people listening today where they don't even think they deserve to try to believe in themselves.
Yep.
Like, they don't even see, like, you know, and a little bit later, I'll tell a little bit of my story and why confidence was such a journey for me, because they may not even be seeing themselves as human,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Yeah, and I really, really want to emphasize that, because, you know, anybody who knows me knows I came straight out of the box as someone with addictions, someone with criminal history, you know, someone who's been divorced, just a lot of really major, what a lot of people call just failures, and I have called failures.
Mm.
But I knew I had to make them into, I knew God gave us mistakes as learning moments. That I knew, and I wasn't going to deny my own self that opportunity.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and all the things I'm hearing you guys talking about, I have experienced that. And the reason I'm mentioning this really fast is because I really want to keep it real. Because while we are laughing and this and that and the other, I don't want anyone for one second to forget the fact that I personally, for example, I have been at lows, broke, bad health, in a wheelchair, etc. I'm not talking about something that's easy. I'm just saying that you can do it. And that's why I think it is important to have that invitation. But I don't mean it really lightly when I say, just do it. Just freaking do it. Like Nike, just do it, you know, because people say that you are supposed to, what, plan for the, hope for the best and plan for the worst. And I've never agreed with that. I think that you should plan for the best and plan for the worst, you know, and hope for the best and plan for it. Because you've got to plan for success.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that takes confidence and it takes time. Yeah. What do you think, Mary?
Well, I totally agree with you. And I love this conversation because I think it's such a powerful piece that, you know, we often don't look at deeply.
Mm-hmm.
And so taking this time to look at it layer by layer is very important.
Yeah.
And I also believe that when, you know, the fake it till you make it phrase, I agree with you, it's kind of an icky phrase. And
right at first, like when you first hear it.
Exactly. But
yeah.
If you turn that around and you take fake out of it, because a lot of us have trouble with that word fake,
mm-hmm.
but I'm going to move forward not quite knowing what I'm going to do next, but I really know that while I'm on that path, I'm going to figure that out.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
And that's for me what it's usually about, is because it's when, and you know, every day I'm starting, you know, in creating new co-creations with all sorts of amazing people out there, you know, who have incredible missions and messages to spread. And so when we're at that starting point of creating a new project or figuring out how we want to work together, there has to be that knowing as we're creating it that we may not know everything at the moment, but it's going to transform what it
is. That you're going
to
figure it out.
And that we're both smart enough and we have the resources and
yeah.
and all of that. And so we always focus at the high-end vision. Mm-hmm. What do we do?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh, let's have some fun.
I like that because you guys, before we started our show, we're talking about something really amazing that happened that fits exactly to the T of what you're talking about, that you have been working for, anticipating
mm-hmm.
for years, 5 years, as a matter of fact.
For me, 8 years.
So, I mean,
yeah.
y'all, again, time is really, really, really important. Love yourself enough to give something enough time.
I like that.
And right. And this idea, though, that with the Drano and everything, remember how Jen was talking about that earlier? The idea that in order to be able to have that endurance for that 8 years, you're waiting for something, you need to be able to continue course correcting along the way with your confidence, because your confidence will get blown off by somebody who says naysaying kind of things and tries to tell you that, no, you are not allowed to do that because I failed before and you can't do that because things. You know, because
that's what guidelines and limitations are for, not to keep you necessarily from something, but to help you seriously be focused. Or
right, but I'm talking about the people who have been so discouraged and have had their dreams broken by other people that they now go around perpetuating misery to other people.
Right.
And there are those people out there, and some people deflate confidence. And so to be able to stay the course long enough to reach a dream, a vision, one of these higher ideal outcomes, you really need to be able to continue replenishing yourself and clearing out the crap that blocks the drain, because it's a daily process. It's my ritual, really. When I see stuff coming up, when I feel people kind of taking me off course, it's like, I have to come back, because this is my mission, this is my purpose, this is why I'm here.
Yeah, and I've seen you do that, and I've seen when you've done that, it's almost like when you finally close that door, like what has opened up for you every time has been incredible, Kat. Like, look at what happened.
It's true. And because when you're listening to that part of your soul that is really the one that wants to be the driving force, the pilot, the one that can move you towards that end destination that God has for you, or the universe has for you, whatever name, Allah, Shakti, Buddha, whatever has for you.
Right.
It doesn't matter. There is that thing for everyone that we are to do. It's our dharma. It's our purpose.
And you deserve to keep looking until you find it.
Exactly. Yes. But it's always going to nudge you back. It's always going to nudge you back. And with all of these processes of looking at this confidence piece and really learning how it factors in to your accomplishment of the goals that you have for your life, I mean, it's huge. It's huge when you can really master this. So...
Yeah. Well, ladies, we got to take another break. Can you believe that? I'm telling you, it just flies. and just so that y'all know, I can take calls while we are on a break. So feel free to call in 949-943-1622. Really, really would love to hear from you. And come find us at truthfindersnetwork.com, because we're hanging out there. I'm in the chat room. And we will come back on the other side, and I'm going to hear from Jennifer about the tool that she's bringing to the table tonight. And this really is a virtual table where we can all come together, brainstorming, encouraging, inspiring to make that change. And anyone can do it. Anyone can do it. It doesn't mean there's not, you know, failures. It just means you get back up and you go again, and you get back up and you go again. And, I mean, at the very least, you could reach out to any one of us and we'll be encouraging you along. I mean, just right there, you've made that connection by just connecting with positive people. So do it. Be thinking about that. And we're going to take a break and listen to a little bit of music. This is a song called Take Me to Church. And it's not a gospel song. So here's this. And so between this one and the other one, I'd say you got about 7.5 minutes to do what you got to do. And then come on back. We'll see you on the other side. And we'll pick this real key to success, confidence, back up again. All right, everybody. See you in a minute.
And then I was born, and I wasn't even kept. My birth mom couldn't do it, and I ended up being, you know, given over for adoption. And that's a totally different story for a different time. But so once again, my second major belief as a child was that. That you're not even wanted. You know? So
yeah.
My first belief.
That's a big deal for a lot of people.
Yeah, you're not even wanted. You don't even need to be here. There's no purpose, you know? And there's a really cool story that of how, like, God addressed that particular belief, but we don't have time to get into it, so maybe there'll be another opportunity later. But so you go from that to me being a kid and being just super, like, crazy hyper ADD. I mean, I would have been diagnosed by the age of 4 if they had that diagnosis then. And I remember in my kindergarten class, we had a rabbit reading group and a turtle reading group, and I needed to be in that rabbit group. I had to show everybody how smart I was. So what I would do to try to fake it till I make it is I would read
right.
really fast to show I could read really well, but then she wouldn't put me in the rabbit group because I didn't have good reading. Like, I didn't pause when I was supposed to pause. So I was in the turtle group. So my first, like, educational thought for me as a kid is, you don't really have what it takes. Because I didn't understand until later as a teacher why I was in the turtle group. As a kid, I was like, man, I'm reading all I got, man. I can't do it any faster.
Why am I
faster? You know, like, I thought rabbits are fast, so we read in the rabbit group.
That's
a fast.
That's
so
awesome.
I was like, she never told me why, you know, so I'm better now.
And when you're a kid, you don't really know how to ask why.
I was like, I
you don't know what to do.
Yeah.
Why am I in the turtle group?
Right.
You know, but then that takes confidence.
Yeah.
I mean, you.
Yeah.
You're so right.
That is so funny. Hmm. So then after that, you know, then I go into middle school, and, oh, man, I teach middle school, and I just, middle school, man, if you have a middle schooler, you just can't hate on them. Like, they've got enough going on, man. It is tough. And, you know,
it is tough.
And my family didn't have a lot of money. I lived in a, you know, like the town that I was in, College Station, Texas, mini A&M, you know, like very conservative, pretty wealthy, you know. For real. So my family didn't have a lot of money. So, like, I didn't have, like, really amazing clothes, you know, like that kind of stuff. I had this crazy Gap, like, buck teeth kind of thing going on. Thank you, Mom, for braces. Like,
right.
Stuff, you know, and that was all the way through high school. And so, like, I mean, I was never like,
and you're so beautiful.
Oh, thank you. But, like, I was never, like, you know, picked on, like, outcasted. But, you know, I had some really horrible friends that said some really mean things, in particular about those weaknesses, you know? So, and then while all this is going on, I'm being abused, which I'm not going to get into all that because that's really deep. But maybe later, you know? So, I mean, you look at my life and you're thinking, when did this kid get a positive message? And I can only think of, like, one person that stands out in my life, and it was a teacher. That's why I became a teacher. He pulled me out in the hallway and he said, Jennifer Pennington, you're too smart, you're too amazing, and you have too much to offer. If you don't quit throwing your life away, I'm going to kick your beep, 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 beep with the coach. And so he got to fill it in, you know, with the right words. So, you know, but overall is a negative message. So after all that, you would expect me to be sitting here today thinking, I'm worthless, I'm stupid, and I don't have anything to offer. And I thought that. I thought that well through my 20s, you know, and that's just not true. That's just not true. So
how did you figure that out? I mean, because this story is a story that a lot of people experience, you know? I mean, like,
yeah.
Like, looking back, because I know from my experience knowing you, and I don't know, it speaks to, like, can you think back to those times in your mid-20s when you were able to bridge that gap? And you had to have started earlier than that.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's the difficult part is basically, like, I just, yeah, it's hard to explain. Hold on, let me think for a second. Okay, so I didn't actually really start working on it until my, until everything really went to crap, you know,
okay.
When, like, the belief systems I had developed were not working for me. Like, it just wasn't working anymore. And it honestly took me well into my 20s to wake up one day and look around and be like, okay, like, I keep putting the same thing out in the world, and I keep getting the same thing back,
mm-hmm.
you know?
It's so true.
And
you're
tired
smart.
Of it.
So
and
you
I'm
were looking.
Smart. I was trying to solve the problem, right?
That's so
I mean,
so
that's
awesome.
Exactly, like, my life doesn't look like what I wanted to do. I don't have the friends in my life that I love, all that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm putting this stuff out there, you know? And, yay! And, sorry. And this is what I'm getting back. And so I just started to work on it, and that's, I was going to read just like a little part of my blog. It's real short, real fast, that kind of talks a little bit about how I started to deal with that. So to say how I sit here today as the woman that I am, I can't answer that question in 5 minutes.
Right.
Because that's going to be, man, that's a lot of work and a lot of beautiful people.
Going back to that thing about it being work.
Yeah.
And you guys, don't let that word work scare you.
No, it's good.
You know,
work.
Because good things come from that, and it feels good, you know. It feels good to be doing that kind of work.
Yeah.
And you're going to get results.
Yeah.
And that feels really, really good. And you're going to find that people around you are noticing those results.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's so true.
You know? And so,
you started seeing and giving them rewards. You know what? Instead of work, I'm going to go back to what you said. Like, what was it? What were we joking about on break? Hashtag, let's pour Drano on that.
Yeah.
Like, it's not really work. It's just pouring some Drano. You know,
like
just
seriously.
Get some of this crap out. You know, it's not hard to lift up a bottle of Drano. You just got to actually get off the couch and do it. So
I'm still learning about this hashtag stuff.
Yeah. Hashtag, let's pour Drano on that. Okay, so this is just a quick thing because I want to be concise with the tool, the particular part about the tool. So I'm just going to read you just a quick excerpt from the blog post that will be out tomorrow. So so it says, confidence is defined as a belief in one's powers or abilities. A lack of confidence is a lack of belief. Here's where I want to refer to our show last week when we talked about belief work. I encourage you to really examine your beliefs. What is holding me back? What do you believe about your power? What do you believe about your ability? Do you stand up in the morning and think, I am strong, powerful person, and I can really do amazing things in the world? If not, what do you think about yourself? Why are you thinking that way? For years, I thought, I'm stupid. I don't have anything to offer. I have no purpose, and on with the negative thoughts. I was allowing years of other people's opinions and hurtful words, indifference and passiveness decide for me what I believe about myself. The last few years, I've decided to stop listening to their beliefs and to begin to search for mine. As I did the belief work that we talked about last week, which you can go back and listen to the archives, you can hear as it was explained in three different ways, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So as I did that belief work that we talked about last week, those people's voices and opinions began to fade in the background, and I began to discover the voice within myself. And that told me that I am powerful, I am strong, and in fact, I have a lot to offer. So why is it worth doing the work? Why is it worth getting the bottle of Drano, pouring it down the drain? Why does having confidence, what does having confidence bring about that makes it worth facing the pain of years or maybe a lifetime? Because sometimes those things that you have to go back to in that belief work, it's wise to work with someone closely, you know, even a professional, you know. So why is it worth going back through that? Because when we are confident, we become a fire for change. We become brave, adventurous,
Amen.
And bold. We take risks.
Fire.
We move forward into new things, and we have what it takes to bring about change. George Bernard Shaw said, life is no brief candle. It is a sort of a splendid torch, which I've got to hold on to for future generations. And so I have a responsibility. It's not just to myself, but it's to a future generation to go forth in confidence. When I finally get to this place where this drain is being unplugged and what comes out of me is so powerful that it's bringing about worldwide change, which I believe that it can. When it's bringing about worldwide change, of course the world's going to get better.
Yeah, that's
you know?
The thing.
And that is
the whole point
niece,
of this conversation.
You know, it's for my niece. I want her to have a good life, you know? My nephew,
And like all these kids that you teach every day that are artistic and
beautiful.
You're
beautiful.
Even taking it a step further and sharing it with them, and we're really, really blessed right now because Debbie's been with us, and since we haven't got to hear from her on some of the other things we talked about, I'm going to try to bring her in really quick. And this is going to get tricky.
I'm here. Can you guys hear me?
We can hear you.
Here I am.
Yay. Okay. I think we can all hear you. I'm going to go like this. And
hi, Deb.
Hey, guys.
Yay!
Sorry for a little late, but here I am.
Everybody, we have got Deborah Hernandez Antich with us finally. She's been in a meeting, a very important thing tonight. And we talked about her earlier in the show, but she's joining us from Leander, Texas, and she's been able to hear because she joined us while Jennifer was talking about the tool that she's brought to the table tonight. And I cannot wait to hear what she has to say about that.
Wow. So what Jen was talking about or like my specific tools?
Well, first, I want to hear what you have, what your thoughts are on what Jen was talking about. And then when we've all, because you missed the first part of it, so I'll catch you up to speed. I don't want to type it to you because then everybody will hear my click, click, click.
No.
But, yeah, so Mary had a chance to share a tool, and then we all kind of chatted about that. And then Katerina did that as well. And Jen, we just came back from a break, and she's been talking about her take on confidence and how she uses it as a tool in her life. And so since you got to actually hear a little bit of that, I thought I would get your thoughts on that real quick, and then I'll get everybody else's, and then we're going to let you bring your tool.
Okay, that sounds good. now, I appreciated what Jen was saying, because it really, to be able to just not be afraid, I think that my tool is that, and so I can kind of hearken it back to what she was saying. Where I've been all night is talking about being able to stand up and not be afraid and be able to kind of share yourself and who you are with other people and why it's important, like she was talking about the Drano, you know, why do that work? And 'cause it's worth it. You know, because it's worth it to...
It's worth it.
You're
worth it.
The greatest thing is that when you learn how to stand up for yourself, then you can stand up for others. And mm-hmm. that, it's like the people that are kind of leading the way, you know, teachers. And Jen, being a teacher, and especially in such a important role for so many people, we kind of talked about that a little bit yesterday, just how... these new kids are here to bring us up to their level. And so it's important for those teachers to be confident and show them, okay, first of all, I believe in you. And second of all, it's worth it. You know, you are worth it. One person is worth it. And so that's what I got out of like what Jen was saying. That was my takeaway.
Yeah, and I love that too, because your takeaway is repetitious in that we've been saying all night, because that's what Mary opened with, is, you know, being worth it, deserving it, being confident, you know, and not letting that lack of confidence, you know, block you. So speaking of Mary, I like Deb's, the way she says, that's my take on it, you know, because really that's what this is all about too, is to spur on everybody's takeaway.
Yeah, totally. And for people to create their own takeaway, you know, to hear.
Exactly.
I miss a little bit of the show, but I, to know all of you guys and to know that each one of you talks about just standing in what's true for you. And then for other people to hear the show and be like, oh, you know what? I agree with a little bit of this and a little bit of that. It's kind of like a little cafeteria. You know, you walk away with the plate that works for you.
Yeah.
And there's no set plate. You know, everybody's plate is important and it's different and it's relative. And that for me is what confidence is about too. Just not sitting back and just knowing that you matter. That we all matter.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. Well, I just have to say, Jen, that it just touches my heart what you shared.
You know, me too.
Aww.
It really touched. I was in tears, you know, and I just closed my eyes and was feeling what you were saying, and I think that that's a big piece of this. Mm-hmm. This is a big piece of having confidence, is knowing that you absolutely are going to choose for yourself something much bigger and something much broader and something much deeper, regardless of what your life has been.
Yeah.
And it does take courage, and but courage and confidence are a momentum.
Yeah, and that's why I put courage as the second C, because I really feel like you have to have confidence. It's progressive. With your confidence comes more courage, and with more courage and confidence comes better character. Mm-hmm. Because it's hard to be the guy that shows up on time when everyone else is late. It's hard to be the one that, stays late every night until everything's done.
Right.
But if you believe in yourself and you believe in that work, even if it doesn't manifest in that job, it will manifest. Mm-hmm. Because someone will bridge the gap to that true value of that, because you believe in yourself and because you never gave up, because you got experience from it.
Yeah.
And you put in the time.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And choosing to be on purpose. Be on purpose in your life. Show up in your life. Choose what is good for you in your life. And what doesn't fit into that category, stop doing it.
Yep.
After
totally.
From working years and years and years, just decades of searching for myself.
Yeah.
And that takes confidence. And it takes courage, but you're worth it.
You're worth it.
Like L'Oreal. You're worth it.
There you go.
Hashtag
come
L'Oreal.
On, baby.
L'Oreal.
You're getting it.
I don't know why I'm hashtagging it, but okay.
She's a Twitter queen.
I want to be. I'm confident that I can be, that's for sure. And I'm going to learn from these girls, that's for sure. What do you think, Kat?
Jen, it just amazes me at how much you've stepped into the business in the past 2 months. Something broke free.
And fake it till you make it. You're wearing it it ain't no new thing.
Well, I've been imagining it for so many years.
There you go. We talked about that, too.
Yeah, that's what I felt. When I kept hanging out with you, you were going through your struggles for the past 2 months, and it was just like, I needed to hang on with you, You're trying to push away. It wouldn't happen. I wanted to stay with you.
Yeah.
Because this is what I was seeing, and I'm like,
this is who I am.
I know it's who you are, and that's what I love, and I'm just like,
I just had too many people treating me negative.
Yeah, you have to drain all that shit.
And that's one of the things that I hope people take from the show, is that they realize, and it's really important to me that people realize that we're just regular girls. That's it. There's nothing. Yeah. I think that we're special in the sense that we've taken these pathways in our life seriously. And that's special. It is.
We're brave. We're courageous.
But anyone can be doing that. We're all born to serve, to be good people, to have integrity, to have character. And, we've got to be true to that. We've got to do that. And like Deb said, it's worth it. We're worth it. And when you put in the time, which, like I said at the beginning of the show, I'm going to keep hammering that one home the whole way. That's my focal point through the night, is to consistently remind everybody that it takes time. And again, you're worth it. It takes time. You got to put the work in. And then be willing to wait to see the results, and believe you will see results, good results.
Yeah.
That's
where faith comes in.
Yeah. Well, that brings us back around to you, girlfriend, Deborah, my Deb. And so I want you to be able to share with all of us the tool that you're bringing. And I'm thinking, let me check this clock real quick. Yep. So we'll have just enough time to talk about it a little bit. And I mean, we literally only have 18 minutes left.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
It happens
fast. So, girl, we're going to hand it over to you fast.
All right. Well, I'll talk quick. I think that the tool for confidence is standing. Like I said, it's standing in who you are so that you can show other. It's all about leading by example. And when you start picking up confidence and building confidence, it draws something that Jen said kind of stuck out to me. And so when you're and not confident in an ego way, I think sometimes people get a little bit not confused. I don't want to use that word, but you know, they say, oh, well, who do you, like, you start to act confident and people that are around you that are wanting you to stay in your little shell and your little spot and your little box, mm-hmm. their instant response is, well, who do you think you are?
Right.
What makes you so special? Why do you think that you deserve to do this? And it's really easy to say, oh, I don't know. Maybe not. Like maybe I'm not special. But like that's one of the things for me is I'm not special. Like I don't stand out. We're all special. And so
right.
many people put so many layers of stuff on top of that they forget. And confidence is just really the practice of remembering who you are and letting that show for other people. And so when you do that, there's two different things that happen. So, and I tell the people this all the time, people are going to love it and be drawn to you, and people are not going to like it and be repelled by you. And it happens inevitably over and over and over again. The people that are repelled, choices to come with you or to stay where they are. And sometimes, and I've had people tell me this, you know, I grew and this person didn't like it. And a lot of times, I mean, it's people in our families, right? Or it's people that are really close to us, like best friends that are like, well, wait, where are you going? I don't want you to go do that. I want you to stay here with me. But people have told me that those people come back around. You know what I mean? And that's really important is whenever you're growing in confidence, knowing that people come back around and people catch up. And I think that's really the big thing for confidence is just knowing that we're all just doing what we're supposed to do. And for some people, it's a little bit longer path than others. But you have to stand in who you are.
I totally agree with that. I mean, I love that. And Kat was saying earlier about holding that space and holding, mm-hmm. you know, that confidence, you know, and imagining that's what you are.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, one of the things that I want to bring to the discussion is, and it really speaks to kind of everything that y'all have been talking about. One of the biggest attractions in my life over the past year has been physics. And
you're really going to start talking about physics at
I am
at the very end of the show. Okay, let's do it.
I am because because I want it to become real for people. You know, I want this conversation that we're having on air to go from being intangible to tangible. And you know, that's one of the things that I really like to do is get my thoughts on paper, because then it goes from being in the air and in my head to in black and white.
Yeah.
And it becomes tangible to me. And then I can start being very black and white about it and, you know, attacking that problem or whatever. And that's the physical part of it. Because if you're just sitting there and the way that you're holding that space is you're stalling or you're in denial or you're binging on something or you could binge on a project for that matter, you know, anything to distract, whatever, you know, but if you take that on believing that you can, believing that it's worth it, that you're worth it, and by making it a physical reality where you are actually doing something about it, a lot of things happen. You know, just the feeling of it going from being in the air and in your head to now, it's something that you're working on. You're physically working on it. And as I've studied physics, you know, one of the things I talk about is how things only are because we're observing them, you know. And if you engage in that physical action of having enough confidence to walk through that action in your life, whatever it is, you're going to see good results. And I just have to encourage everybody listening to have the enough love for yourself to have the confidence that these things work, you know, because the only thing you can do to prove it's wrong is try it. and that takes a little bit of confidence, but you're worth it. And, you know, the physics of it is just the things that you guys have been talking about, where you're imagining it, you know, and you're taking it from out there and you're making it a reality in your mind, which causes it to become a physical manifestation. You know, you talked earlier about imagining something all your life, and I got a vision, you know, 20 years ago of a lot like what we're doing now. And this is a physical manifestation of something that I have believed in even when I didn't even want to. Mm-hmm. But I believed in it for so long and in such a great way that in the waning times, yeah, I remembered, oh my gosh,
no, this is what I really want.
This is what I really want. Like, I believe this. So, you know, I'm just saying that you hear us talk and we share these things. But the truth is that this is reality. And this is what it looks like. And this is what it takes to make that change in your life. Okay? Bottom line, you have to have confidence. And like Jen was saying, if you don't have the confidence, you know, ask yourself, okay, wait a minute. What am I missing here? What's wrong? Why do I think this? Why do I feel this? And get black and white with it. Write it down on a piece of paper or on your computer, whatever, you know, and commit yourself to it and the solution. And like you said, Deb, you know, stand that ground. Stand your ground. Hashtag stand your ground. But not in the way that our country got feverish. But in a new way, stand your ground, man. Don't let other people's small belief in you be your small belief in you.
Yeah.
I'd say we've got, let's see, we can hear from everybody for like a couple minutes. So I'll hand it over to you real quick, Mary. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I'm just really grateful for all the time that we've had here today. And what I'm able to come away with is that I can resonate with each and every one of these stories and each one of these perspectives on how to bring more confidence into one life. And what I really want to encourage people to do is to take a deeper look within themselves and look for those places where they are lacking confidence or places where they're not doing things that they really want to be doing in their life. And they look deeper at that. But then also, you know, you don't need to spend a lot of time on the baggage.
Right.
You can choose to come to peace with things, and some things need your attention. You could also choose
Take
to
your
move
battle.
Forward. Exactly. And start working on that bucket list. Start moving forward in your life and let go of the past. That's what I'm going to leave it with.
I like that a lot. Kat?
I love this conversation. I'm actually getting messages from people real time who are watching the show, and there's a young girl, she's a teenager, her name is Rochelle,
and she's watching the show, and she said that, I'm just really not used to hearing conversations like this from girls. I like it, you know?
Wow.
And then Dave, the person who's also simulcasting the show, said, I know, those ladies aren't used to it either. Neither am I. Welcome to global paradigm shift.
And that's the and take this away. Like, thank you to the 16-year-old listener, because I'm getting confidence from that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
To know that, because, you know, it's a determination. 18.
Sorry.
Those 2 years count for sure. But it's like, that tells me that what we're doing matters.
It does.
That it will matter. And wow.
That for me is the whole reason.
That made my.
I do this.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Ditto.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Rochelle.
Thank you, Rochelle. And I hope you keep listening.
And David, too, for simulcasting.
Thank you.
Get us
on Facebook.
Yes,
on
do.
Facebook.
Yeah, like, let's
She's
put,
so happy, apparently.
Where did,
take
wait.
This conversation there. I mean, because, and that makes
me.
I can't either. What happened to Deb?
You can't hear me?
Now we hear you.
Okay. So I wasn't trying to cut anybody off, but I was just saying Facebook is a great place to continue this conversation and staying, you know, kind of throughout the week, checking in and contacting. And I want listeners.
Facebook page.
Yeah.
Make that change, y'all. And it would be a really, really good place to do that. And you all can Facebook me, and I will. Well, you can find us, each of us. Our names are highlighted as hyperlinks in the page information on the Blog Talk Radio show page. So you can connect with each of us there. And, you know, I'll friend you on Facebook and exchange that with you. And I think all of us feel the same way. I mean, we're really just here to try to pass on what we are blessed enough to know because of our experiences. And we are also blessed to have the tools of our time, which really inspire me, you know, because they didn't have this stuff 100, even 50 years ago, even when I was a kid. And, you know, we're going to have one conversation tonight, right? And it's going to become a podcast. And then we're going to all share it and share it and share it. And it really will be that situation when one conversation becomes an endless amount of conversations. So, you know, it's our voice, and we got to be game changers for ourselves, for each other, for others. And so that's what I want to give to you all tonight. I got to hear from everybody a little bit on Deb's thoughts, except for Jen.
Oh, I just want to
And we have, like, I don't know, 5 minutes.
Okay, I just have a minute because I just want to quote Deb, because Deb, like, as you were speaking, like, I literally got chills with things that you were sharing. I just was like, put a hashtag in. Hashtag standing in your confidence. Like, I love that. Just standing in who you are and not letting
anyone
else take that. I love,
standing in your confidence.
You know, no matter what you say. I know.
Like football players
stand. Yeah, like, you can say whatever you want. You can try to tell me or look at me any way that you want, but, like, I'm okay.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to stand.
You aren't going to say boo to me.
Yeah.
That was down my ground.
I'm not going
to try me, baby. Try me.
Yeah.
Hashtag remember who you are.
Right. So, and then I like that confidence is the practices of remembering who you are.
Oh, my gosh.
The daily practice. I love, like, you know, like, we talked a little bit about, like, getting into your path, being your path with your confidence. But I love, like, Deb, you just brought something so practical for today of this, like, I'm not digging in my past right now, but look, I'm going to stand with what I am, and I'm going to practice. I'm going to be intentional about remembering who I am. When someone comes at me and they say, and they roll their eyes at the promotion you got because they're jealous they didn't get it, instead of taking that on, it's going to be like, man, I deserve that promotion. Like, I'm going to stand in my confidence. Like, thank you. You're welcome. You know, I received that.
Yeah.
You know, I
mean, the truth is, you know, if you're doing really good, sometimes you make other people look bad. But that's not your problem.
That's my fault.
That's not your problem, you know?
Yeah.
And you can't let that be your own, how you define yourself. No, you know, what about all the time that you put in? What about the school that you've done, you know, the schooling that you've done? You know, what about the experiences that you've survived? You know, you've been through all of those things. And, you know, it's, I always like to say, a lot of times, you know, I remember when I was in real estate and women would get, they'd be intimidated because I was thin and I'd had a bunch of kids, or because I was happily married, or maybe I had a nice car. But it's like, well, did you think that I woke up with that car with a big red bow
exactly.
on it? Mm-hmm. I mean, did you think that my husband was just there one day, one morning with a big bow? I mean, all of the things that I have in my life that from the outside in, somebody may be envious of or think, oh, well, how did she do that? Well, I had to wait at work. And I had to try really hard, and I had to go through failures and all that. But I also knew that I had to believe in myself. And I tried to surround myself with others who do. And as you could hear, we have just a few seconds left. So I just really want to thank my guests, Deborah Hernandez-Antich, Mary Adams, Katerina Roy, and Jennifer Pennington. This has been Make That Change. And the episode for tonight is Tools of Transformation. The first of the three C's, confidence. And again, you can find us at truthfindersnetwork.com and co-creatornetwork.com and livefreelywithjen.weebly.com. And also, I don't want to mess up Deb's.
iprojectconfidence.com.
Yes, iprojectconfidence.com. And let's see. And yes, I really, really want to invite Rochelle to call in next week. And just knowing that you will gives me confidence and makes me excited. I just feel, I don't know, you made my night. But on that, I just want to thank you all so much for, and also don't forget KaterinaRoy.com. That's how you can reach her. Sorry about that. I'm trying to like get all my little mentions in. So same time next week, Monday night, 8 p.m. Central Standard Time. Thanks, y'all. Have a blessed and safe week.